Give you an opportunity to talk about a little about friends you may have had in your early life or adolescence.
I want to tell you about one friend in particular. He's 90 years old. His name is John Swomley. He was ordained as a Methodist minister. He also received his PhD, I forget from what university, in social theology. I mean the theology which directs itself towards believing in the rights of other people. And he lived in Kansas City. He still does live in Kansas City. He's my best non-Jewish friend. And I might even eliminate the non-Jewish part of it, except that I'm not so sure, but that he is my best non-Jewish friend goes without saying. He was the one who called me back in 1964, and he said, "I heard you talk the other day. I was a guest at a bar mitzvah, and I heard you talk, and I think you're the kind of guy who would act favorably to my idea about organizing a clerical group in our community whose purpose it would be to sound off against the killing that we are doing in a country which is so far away and in which our only interest could be imperialistic." So that's how Swomley, John Swomley and I joined together to found a chapter of the Clergy United in the against the war in Vietnam. We sent out, this is the thing, I have to tell you this story. We sent out letters setting out the purpose of this about to be formed group to all of the clergymen in the greater Kansas City area. That was 1,143. I remember the number. 1,143 letters went out to join us for the initial meeting of this group at the Country Club, the Christian Church. By the way, it was called the Country Club Christian Church because the area is the Country Club. That's the title, as you would say, Riverdale. This was Country Club, a portion. So the Country Club Christian Church, I might say that the two are really antithetical. If you're a church, you shouldn't be Country Club. But anyway, that's where, because the Reverend Lawrence Bass, who was at that time the minister of the church, one of the most prominent churches in town, became a part of this group to begin with. Out of these over 1,100 letters that we sent out, how many people joined us? I'll tell you how many people. I'm asking you the question, and I'm saying that we were joined by a total of 14 people. These 14 people, however, were with it all the way. But as we walked out, I was my chin fell, and I looked very sad. And John Swomley walked out with me. He said, "Morris, don't be discouraged. 14 can move a community. One can move a community. It's not a question of numbers. It's a question of inspiration, conviction. Please keep your chin up." And I remember that not only for the sake, for the duration of that infamous war, which cost so many lives, millions of lives actually, but for the duration of my career. I remember the words of John Swomley, who's still active, still 90 years old, he's still in there fighting. And you know what he's fighting now? He's fighting all of the evil that we see around us in the world today and in Washington and elsewhere. But that's a story in itself.
think we'll take a break for...